Puget Sound, the jewel of Western Washington. First discovered in 1792 by British explorer George Vancouver, Puget Sound covers 2,642 square kilometers and serves the largest cities in Washington State, Seattle, and Tacoma. One of the largest naval shipyards on the Pacific Coast resides on Sinclair Inlet. The largest ferry system in the United States and fourth in the world crisscrosses its straits and channels on a daily basis. But that's not what we're here to talk about. We're here to talk about what's below the surface. Surprisingly, for being a Puget Sound dock, there was very little kelp or barnacles on the sides. Also inside the breakwater were many members of the Sibylidae family, ones that we have identified as Eudystia vancouveri, a feather duster worm. The breakwater was a different story. As we went from the calm waters inside the marina to the choppy waters of uninhibited Sinclair Inlet, we noticed almost nothing but kelp grew on the outside of the breakwater. I guess anemones couldn't really last outside. One of our best outings was at the Portage Marina, just across Sinclair Inlet from the Bremerton Marina. Expecting much of the same, we were positively surprised at what we'd found. We saw many Aurelia arita, or the nadaria we call moon jellyfish, gracefully swimming across the marina. The male and female jellyfish can be distinguished by their different colored gonads, the horseshoe-looking organs in the tops of their caps. The females are distinguished by more colored gonads, thus going against natural precedent that the males are always the flashy one in order to distract predators from attacking the females, like seen in these mallard ducks.
Jellyfishing, 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 jellyfishing!
While walking down the dock, a shimmer in the water caught my eye. As I went to investigate, I found a school of Hypomyces pretosus, the scientific name for surf smelt, meandering its way around the boats. On the inside of the breakwater, we found a nice specimen of the genus Pisaster, curled around a bolt head protruding out from the dock. Several others were nearby. A real nice find, though not too visible on camera, was a type of waterfall that the crew was not able to identify, but the camera was able to catch the return to the surface and the dive before it decided it was not ready for its close-up. That's right, Mr. DeMille, it's not ready for its close-up.
Thank you. So, sir, how was the clam bake for you? So it was good.
Our crew, along with location scout Kelly Rogers, filmed at Harper's Pier on the 18th of April. This dock recently replaced an ancient car ferry turned fishing pier that was in operation since the time of the Mosquito Fleet. As you can see, the pier's supports are very clean, even though the dock has been finished since 2015. This can possibly be attributed to the fact that the pier is in a sheltered harbor, and not much of the current hits the pier itself.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
New from Rock Lobster, it's the 5-course starfish dish. Served with a pile of digestive glands, plenty of female gonads, the top of the pyloric stomach, and 2 whole starfish rays, only for $29.95 plus tax. Here are some testimonials for the 5-course starfish dish.
Well, I thought it was very evenly preserved and tasty.
Well, it was very set.
God damn it, that's the third interview this week.
Saturday the 23rd saw the film crew, along with location scout Darwin Rogers, film along the Hood Canal, specifically at the mouth of the Skokomish River. The river was quite clear, but no animals were caught. However, this shows the fast-flowing current of the massive runoff river that reduces the salinity of this area in Puget Sound.